three times a charm, baby. Thoughts from a boss, man. I feel like I take my time this time, man. We're gonna talk about redemption, man. I just spent 2 weeks in the hospital, man. I just lost 30 pounds. They took my spleen out. I got broken ribs, man. My thumb is dislocated. Yeah, man. But you know what? I'm grateful. I'm thankful. I'm still here, man. I'm still breathing. Let's talk about redemption today, baby. We all got a purpose. What's yours? I'm coming back from my uncle's funeral. I'm on my motorcycle. I remember pulling up to the front of the light because we don't wait in the back. We pull up to the front. This lady turned across all the lanes right into me. All the police reports say she hit me. I remember seeing her pull out. The next thing I know, it was, yo, buddy, your thumb is dislocated. I'm gonna put it back. I woke up in the hospital. Let's talk about redemption. The Lord will do it for you if you let him. So I got my tea. I know I don't get many views and nothing like that, but I was being consistent on posting. At least, you know, dropping a few jewels every now and then. Maybe not even making sure if it made sense all the way. I don't rehearse these videos. When the Spirit moved me, I move, even in the hospital. I think I came down from the heavens to give the no-jumper motherfuckers a piece of game. Pull their coattails just a tad bit for this redemption, baby, because God is good. I don't know how many of y'all had near-death experiences, man, but wow. That's all I can say, man. Wow. Amazing. I'm not gonna say I met with nothing, I seen no lights or nothing like that, nigga. I went to sleep and woke up in a different spot, nigga. No recollection. I didn't feel the impact. Motherfucker said I came down super cyan. This lady's car totaled her car on the hood and she stopped. I slid off into the grass and hey. So let's talk about it, man. When the Lord got you, man, and he wants you for a purpose, man, you gotta answer that call, man. You understand what I'm saying? The devil tries you, man, but it ain't your soul to sell in the first place, man. Right before this accident, you know, for that whole week, I was contemplating hard if I should go back to my job. I've been out of work for about 2 years doing tattoos professionally for 2 years. I've been out of work. That's all I've been doing, bro. Yeah. And I felt like when I had that urge to call my job back, I think I even talked to a couple people's mind. I was telling myself the devil is a lie. Now look at me, man. I'm 2 weeks left. I've been out, bro. I ain't got that 401k. I ain't got that health insurance benefits from the jobs, man. I'm in the jungle, homie. I'm a wounded animal, homie. Nigga, I got staples in my shit, homie. Yeah. I could have died. You know what that type of shit do to a man? I can still think, I'm cognizant. I can smell, taste, touch, breathe, walk, talk. All my fingers and shit work. Look, even the thumb in there working, baby. Toes. And that extra stick worked too. Yeah. So now it's about redemption, baby. Why not be the best version of me that the Lord could ever possibly want me to be? Have anybody ever closed their eyes and envisioned themselves at tip top? Some things, you know, you gotta go through. You can't get testimonies without testing. So I'll be a testament. That's all. This is thoughts from the boss, man. We gonna keep coming at you, man. Somebody stay motivated. Somebody gonna hear this. Somebody gonna be inspired. Somebody gonna be like, man, that man been through a lot. But he's still ticking, man. He's still smiling. He's still grooving. He still got his spirits up high. He's still drinking his tea. Well, I be getting all flavors of that tea, man. You know, that's just something I do. You know? So since I've been in the hospital, I got a complete flushed out of my stomach. Like, man, it's like a thorough colon cleanse. They already told me most of the shit that they did, man. This shit crazy. But it's like little small things in the physical for the Lord, like, you know what I'm saying? For a person like me, man, it's hard for me to rely on people to do things, you know what I'm saying? I've had to rely on people to do things for me. You understand what I'm saying? I can't even cut my own nails, man. I went and got my nails cut and manicured today for the first time, you know what I'm saying? I wouldn't let somebody else cut my hair. You know what I'm saying? I cut my own hair. I had, you know what I'm saying? And it's not that. These are just things that I'm accustomed to doing. I do this shit for myself once a week. I've been locked in the hospital for 3 weeks, bro. You should have seen it. Y'all seen my last couple videos, man. I ain't had no beard and shit like that, man. Probably still finna chop that off too and shit, but you know what I'm saying? Everything else, like going to get the haircut, you know what I'm saying? The manicure, pedicure, shit like that, man. You know what? I thank you, Lord. I enjoyed it. You feel me? I genuinely enjoyed it. Man, you understand? I ain't never really treated myself like that. You know what I'm saying? I ain't never treated myself like that. I ain't never, ever treated myself like that, man. And now here I am, man. Treating myself. You know what I'm saying? And it's due to, because I have to. You know what I'm saying? These are the things that I have to get done. I have to get these grooming done. You know what I'm saying? I still gotta look presentable. You know what I'm saying? That's part of my daily job as well. Is looking presentable. You only get one chance to make a first impression, man. After that first chance to make that first impression, you don't get no second ones, my nigga. No second ones. So, you know what I'm saying? It's up to you to stay in tip top. It's up to you to be the cream of the crop. Now, I mean, not everybody gonna want to be that. Not everybody wanna take that route. You know what I'm saying? But them choices that you gotta make. This life is short, man. I'm a living testament of that, boy. This life is short. I thought I was gone. Man, I got too much work to do, man. I don't care if it's just one person that hear this, man. I know this, man. Y'all ain't gonna see no subscriptions, subscribing, no, man. Y'all come get this game, man, because this is knowledge learned, it's knowledge earned. You know what I'm saying? You got to be tested to get a testament and not be a testament for the testimonies. You understand? For the ceremonies, and I ain't trying to get the rhyming up on you, but if you want to come through, my niggas, stop playing with me. Man, listen, man, you're trying to enjoy this life, man. I'm just so grateful right now. You know what I'm saying? I'm just so grateful right now, man. Man, I'm back at home. Motherfucker, you ever been driving home and it took you 2 weeks to get done? That's basically what just happened to a nigga, man. You feel me? Nigga just glad to be home, baby. You know what I'm saying? hug your kids, kiss your wives, you know what I'm saying? Call your mama, your daddy, your cousins, you know what I'm saying? Tell your homeboys and all that shit. Even your haters, man. Even your haters, man. Tell them. Yeah. It feels good sometimes, though, man. Thoughts from a motherfucking boss, man. I'ma holler at you at all costs.